It's time to take your use of artificial intelligence to the next level.
Get an exclusive sneak peek at our new course, How to Use AI to Supercharge Your Work. Three leading AI experts go beyond the basics to share practical strategies you can apply immediately to perform at your best. Like what you see? Visit smarter.cnbcmakeit.com to unlock a special introductory offer.
Advanced prompting is really just about providing additional detail and more context. When I think about basic prompting and how that is distinguished from advanced prompting, if I have a cupcake business, I might have a prompt that says, create a slogan for my business, and that's it. That might be a simple, basic prompt that I would use. Whereas an advanced prompt, I think of that as giving more context and more background to the AI tool. So I'm going to think more about what my output is, and I might say, give me 5 versions of marketing slogans for my social media campaigns in Twitter and Instagram and LinkedIn. Make sure you use a bulleted style and end with a call to action that refers people to my website, and I might also include my website, right? Thebestcupcakes.com.
I like to tell people the best prompts are ones where you talk to the large language model like you would talk to a human. So I've taught over 15,000 people live for the last 3 years on our prompting process called Prime Prompt Polish. And I think more than anything, it's getting people out of the mindset that I get one input and one output out of a large language model. So all that means priming is going through, it's sharing context with a model. And the first thing, your first message that you send to a model isn't for an output, right? It's essentially, here's everything I'm working on. Here's what I'm trying to do. Here's context specific to my situation, the output of what I essentially want and how I want that outlined. But before we go any further, what questions do you have? What clarifications do you need? And this works whether you're using ChatGPT, Gemini, Copilot, Claude, it doesn't matter. And then eventually there's going to get to a point where you and the model have had enough back and forth where you're like, okay, I'm ready to prompt. So prompting is the first time you're actually asking for an output, whatever that is, outlining your board presentation, getting that next draft for a blog post, whatever it is, the prompting, you actually go through a lot more priming. Prompting is very easy. That's once you've gone through the priming process, that's your first output. And then polishing, that's going from first draft to final draft, right? As a former journalist, I remember the first story you hand in never makes it to print, right? You sometimes had to go through 3-4 rounds of different editors, a lot of red ink, a lot of back and forth. And I think the same thing is true with large language models. Giving the model, hey, I asked for this type of output. You gave me the output in this way. It's good in these ways. It's bad in these ways. You have to be extremely specific. You need to describe, you know, is it the output length? Is it the style? Is it the word choice? I think it's important to use more words, use more context, and also have more iterations. Quiz the model, have it quiz you to make sure that the two of you are ultimately on the same page and give it explicit and step-by-step directions on what needs to be improved. So yeah, it just depends on what you're ultimately going for, but I don't think there's necessarily words to avoid per se when it comes to inputting something in a large language model.